Today is part three of our golden rules of RTD measurement. Installation hints which make your measurement better. Hi, I'm Dietmar. I'm senior application engineer for temperature measurement at Endress+Hauser. I'm working in the business for some decades and I want to share my expertise with you. We have seen in the both previous episodes that the gradient, which is produced inside the thermometer assembly, has an effect on the resulting accuracy. So the choice of the sensor can make your measurement better, but what else can you do? To make you understand, let's start at this. Usually the customers ask for short insertion lengths for small pipes and so on. What happens here is the gradient between the inner side of your process connection and the process temperature is very steep. And if we insert a standard measurement insert in this assembly, we will see we cannot see the process temperature because at the position where the primary element is, there is not the process temperature. We typically indicate too less. To reduce this mistake, if possible, try to enhance the length of the wetted part inside the process, because then the resulting gradient becomes less steep. And so we measure the temperature at a position which is closer to the real process temperature. So that means we reduce the resulting mistake a lot. So insertion lengths should be as big as possible. But typically, if you're measuring in a pipe, you will touch the other side of the pipe. So in this case, it is possible to increase the insertion length by the installation with an angle. If you have 45 degrees or whatever, the wetted part of the thermometer becomes longer, so the gradient becomes more flat, and so the mistake is smaller. The best choice would be the installation in an elbow, because obviously there is no other side which you can touch in an elbow. And to be honest, so far I've never seen a process plant without any elbows or curves or whatever. So there's only maybe if you have a pipeline at the ground of the sea, so that where you have no elbow. So typically you will find a position where you can install a longer thermometer into the process, and typically it is against the flow. So as always, there's a but. A very long and thin construction might be not that stable, and so it is necessary to find out if this is safe enough. And there are rules in the Thermowell calculation programs where you can check the lengths, the maximum tolerable length of an installation inside a plant. So make the insertion lengths longer, check the Thermowell calculation. What else can you do to make your measurement better? Starting from the initial gradient, it can help to insulate the outside of the pipe to make the measurement in the inside better. That's why, because you increase the temperature level of the outside, you will also affect the inside, because you cut the amount of energy which is disappearing by the flange. And so the flange outside becomes hotter, the flange inside becomes hotter, and so the resulting gradient inside the process again becomes less steep, and as the length, the same effect, flat gradient, less mistake. Hope you like it. If yes, watch out for the next video of the series and leave us a comment, a like, or share.